Hello everyone, welcome you back for the discussion on the channels and as well as the walls. Now here, as you know that the design and as well as the fabrication which plays a major role that especially with respect to the devices that which are implanted in the human body or it may be in the systems. Now the most important things that we are discussing is nothing but the channels and as well as the walls. Now here the channel as the microfluid channels are the most important component in the microfluid system, which depicts a simple form and as well as a functionality. It is a complicated one, that too especially a pumps and as well as a walls. As you know that our body, it consists of the n number of motors and even the pumps and even the walls. The selection of the channel and as well as the channel material is starting point of any development effort in the case of the microfluidic systems. There are several important aspects that must be taken in consideration with respect to the selection of the channel material and also the fabrication methods, because these channel materials and also the fabrication methods leads to a problem in the human implantation also. For that reason, the channel materials is also plays a major role. Now these includes either it may be a hydrophobicity. The liquid moves freely in the channel as the hydrophilic walls by capillary action, or it may be a simplifying a sample of the loading in imprinting. The glass is, for example, is a hydrophilic in many liquids and its properties are well known. There are two different materials, are there, hydrophobic materials and as well as the hydrophilic materials. Now depending upon the type of the applications, even these materials are also used. The second one is nothing but a biocompatibility and also chemical compatibility. As you know that the channels and also the walls what we are using in the case of the human implantation, it should be a biocompatible and also the chemical compatible in nature. It means that it has to quantifying with respect to the biological aspect and also the chemical aspect. After ascertaining these, it can be implanted very easily, and also these it can be processed, that especially for the micro machining applications. The next part is with respect to the permeability of the channel material to the air and also liquid. As you know that the bloods are nothing but the carriers of the air and also the liquid. High permeability will cause us a expensive loss of the fluid, and also in case of the multiple channels and place close to each other in the cross contamination. The retention of the chemical wall. The walls that retains the chemical may cause us the cross contamination during the repeated use. The optical transparency is also another facilitates the observation and also the quantitative assay of the analysis. The temperature of the processing. This is another major concern with respect to the material. Here, there are so many different types of materials which lies under the category of the high temperature application and also low temperature application. The low temperature processing is always desirable. High temperature processing would be a narrow of the choice of the structural and also the surface coating materials. The functional complexity is also another major concern, and the last is nothing but the development cost. The barriers of the prototype and also the manufacturing should be low. See, these are all the concern with respect to the fabrication of the channels we have to think of. Now in the channels, especially with respect to the channels, as we know that the materials what we are using, it should be a biocompatible, or it may be a chemically stable, chemical compatibility, permeability, and even the retention ratios, or it may be the retention ratios with respect to the chemical content, and also the temperature processing, the functionality aspects, it should be considered. Now in the early days, the microfluid systems developed and also the applications of the channels and as well as the walls are often made up of the inorganic materials Nowadays, the most of the materials are MEMS based, which is of the silicon, or it may be silicon dioxide, or it may be silicon nitride, or even the polycrystalline silicon, and even the metals are also used. The fabrication process includes either it may be a bulk etching, either it may be a dry etching, or it may be a wet etching, and in the process of the wafer to wafer bonding is also one of the step in the fabrication of the channels. A few representative fabrication methods are illustrated in the next slide. Now here in this case, there are three different processes are there. Here in this case, the fabrication, it is based on what we can say, the two thing is here, one is with respect to the substrate, the another one is with respect to the sacrificial layer. Now over which, on the substrate, the sacrificial layer has been placed. On the sacrificial layer, a channel cross section is being constructed. Now the channel cross section, once if it is constructed, a channel wall is built up. These channel walls, after building up, the channel cross section, which is used as a material, that it is removed. See, this is a method which has been adopted in the construction of the channel. That too, especially these channels, what it has been constructed, and as well as fabricated in different shapes and as well as with different dimensions depending upon the type of the applications. Now the materials for the channels have evolved rapidly in the past few years. The organic polymers, like either it may be a pyrrolidine, or it may be the acrylics, or it may be polycarbonates, or it may be biodegradable polymers, are having a major application. Even there are some inorganic materials are also there. Those are either it may be a silicon, silicon dioxide, silicon nitrides, and polysilicons are having a major application with respect to the channels. The walls are also important with respect to the element in the case of the microfluid systems. They provides what we can say a complex system level functionalities and also laboratory on chips. The following factors that is to be considered generally, especially in the case of the repeatability of the wall operations, are nothing but with respect to the ability to withstand the large pressures, and as well as the simplicity in with respect to the construction, and also simplicity in the operation and control. The biocompatibility of the fluid is also another biological concern we have to taken into the consideration. Now even with respect to the walls also, there are so many different types of materials, and also the membranes are there. The hard membrane wall, the soft membrane wall, the plug walls, and also the threshold walls. These walls are also having a major application, especially in the human implantations.